Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. In this video, I wanted to show you another very useful use case of stability matrix. As you can see, you can have several different web UIs installed at the same time. And as I mentioned in the last video, they share the models with each other, so you can take the LoRAs you downloaded with Stable Diffusion Web UI and use them in SD Next Web UI or Vladmantic as well. But when you install Vladmantic SD Next Web UI, you have something special in here. You got a lot of options when it comes to upscalers, as you can see here. SD Next Web UI comes with a lot of different upscaling versions and chained variants and different upscaling models for different use cases. And the list is very long. But when you use them for upscaling of an image, it downloads the respective upscaler to your models folder. And when you load Stable Diffusion Web UI, the normal version, you also have those upscalers which you downloaded before in Vladmantic inside Automatic 1111, for example. That's very useful because normally you don't have that many options, and it's basically only taking the options which are really compatible and shows them when you boot it up. So just try it yourself, and if you want to have more information on the different upscalers, just look into the other videos I will create on this topic. There I will compare the different upscalers and use cases and basically which is most useful for which case, at least to my best ability. Another useful resource for upscaler information in general would be OpenModelDB if you want to explore it yourself. There are a lot, and I mean a lot of different upscalers and descriptions how they work and how they are supposed to be used and how efficient they are, but it's a lot. If you want to take a look, I will leave the link in the description. But aside of that, thank you very much for your time, and I will see you next time. Goodbye.